Hi everyone, in today's video I'm gonna talk more about tables. I'm gonna talk about formulas briefly. I'm gonna talk about how to convert the table into text and vice versa. This is the table that we used in the last video, and I just removed the formatting. I kept simple formatting only, and I'm gonna add a formula in it. So I'm gonna go to the table tools layout. I'll insert a row at the end, so I'll click at the last row and insert below in the ribbon, and here I'll choose formulas. So in the table tools layout tab, I'll go to this formula button and click on it, and I'll choose the sum of those that are above. I also have the number format. If I wanna do some formatting, maybe I can put currency. So this is it, and I'll click on OK, and this is the sum. So it added the currency automatically. That was the sum of the cells that are above it. Let's do that again. I'll click on this cell, and I wanna take the average of the income. So I click on the formula button, and this time instead of sum, I'll type average of the above, and again I'll add this currency formatting, and OK, that's the average. We'll talk more about formulas in Excel, so I think that's enough when it comes to formulas in Word. If you want something more advanced, you can insert an Excel spreadsheet into your Word document. Now, I'll take this table, I'll select it, and I'll go to the Table Tools layout again, and this time I'll click on Convert to Text. It will ask me how do I want to separate my text, so it will separate the cells. Between every cell and another, what do I want as a separator? I can choose tabs, I can choose commas, I can choose other. Let's go with tabs and click on OK. And that's my table. And these are the tabs. You can see the non-printing characters showing that I have tabs between one cell and another. And here I can move my tabs. Or if I undo that, I'll do it again. Table tools layout. Convert to text. This time I'll choose other and go with ampersand. This is my table, and I can see the ampersand separating between cells. Let's do the opposite now. So I'll select this row. I'll go to insert table and select convert text to table. Now we have to be careful. It's asking me first of all how many columns do I want, and I want two columns, so I'll type 2. The autofit behavior is left. I leave it to auto. You can change it to fit contents or to fit the window. And you can choose how the text is separated. Now I have a comma separating my text, and this might cause me a problem, in fact. So we have to be careful when we type a text and how shall we separate it. So I click on OK and show you what the problem is. I selected my separator as a comma, and that's OK. I had 0, 5, and this put the 0 in a cell and the 5 in another. So again, I had 0, 5, and when I changed it into a table, the 0 appeared in one cell and the 5 appeared in another. So if I want to stick with comma as my separator, I have to change this to 0.5. Now if I select this, I go to insert tab, table, convert text to table, and I select 2, and then I keep the separator as a comma and I choose auto fit to contents. That's it. This time I changed the auto fit behavior. And that's what I'll obtain. Let's do this again with another example. So I'm gonna select these, and this time if you notice, the separator is this asterisk mark. So I'm gonna go to insert table, convert text to table. I'll say that I have 2 columns, but this time I'll change the separator to commas, which is wrong, and click on OK. I have I don't have good separation. I'll undo this, and this time if I go to insert table and convert text to table, I have to choose my separator as other and select this asterisk mark. I have two columns, and OK, that's what I obtain. Again, I can format this. But this is not my header row, so I'll insert another row. So table tools layout, insert row above, and this time I'll type website IP address, and I've obtained a new table from the text that I had. So that was it for today. Thanks for watching.